Welcome to everybody to open mic. I invited Jeff Nelson tonight to be our MC, and because I knew he would say funnier stuff than I would. So welcome, Jeff.
Hi. When Brenda asked me to do this, I was delighted. I was thinking to myself, it would be a wonderful way for us to be able to all get together in the evening. I started to pitch some ideas for what I might say, and I could tell by the end of the telephone call that Brenda had already begun to regret her decision. I thought about this and I realized, at St. Andrews, I'm probably the person most likely to be voted somebody who would turn themselves into a human microphone, but I want you to know that I see this as a serious thing and I would never do anything like that. I don't have the shoulders to be a human microphone. So with no further ado, we're going to start moving on with the program. We have a wonderful set of performances for you tonight. And we're going to start with Brenda. Brenda's going to read us some poetry.
Thank you. Yeah, when I decided since this was my idea, I better participate. And love that human microphone. That's nice. After the performance, we'll unmute everybody so you can applaud and hear each other. And then we'll mute everybody again. This poem is called Blue Morning Glory by Ann Pitkin. Voracious, yes, but when you see it, shy blue flower blaring like trumpets in spite of themselves, center stars shaped and yellow when it startles you. Early in the morning, all over a white picket fence, say in Massachusetts, you might think triumphal, prodigal, awake. Of course, you don't want it in your rose garden among all the pruned decorous bushes. You don't want it in the vegetables, for it will romp through the tomatoes, beans, and peas, and will leave no room on the ground or even in the air for the leafy lettuces and cabbages soberly queuing up in their furrows. It will hog all the sky it can get, knowing as it does what enormous thirst is satisfied by blue. Father Michael says, follow the God of abundance, says we hurry from the moment's wealth for fear it will be taken. Think of this. The morning glory has been blossoming for so long without permission that in some gardens it is no longer censored. What does that tell you? See it open its tender throats to a world that can sting it, how without apology for its excess, it blooms and blooms, though even yet it seems surprised.
Thank you, Mother Brenda, that was beautiful. So I wanted to mention that I put behind me a graphic of the Montserrat Monastery in Barcelona, Spain. It's a wonderful place. If you ever go to Barcelona, don't miss it for any reason. The reason I wanted to put it up there, though, is because we had gone through the gift shop, and it wasn't manned at the time. It was one of those honor things, and we picked up a postcard and thought, we're going to have to go back there and bring a payment for it. But the next morning, we had to race to the gondola and get down to the trolley and take off for our next spot on our trip. And we realized we left behind stuff that we absolutely needed. And so 2 days later, they had told us from Montserrat that they found the stuff that we left behind. We had to rent a car and drive 200 miles across the west of Spain or the east of Spain in order to retrieve it. We missed a part of our trip, but we ran quickly to put money at the gift shop because we realized that this silly mistake had been caused because we've been cursed by the virgin statue that was there. Was a jealous goddess, and so we didn't make that mistake again. Anyway, next up, we have Ruby Belt, who is a new member here at St. Andrews. Ruby, what have you got for us?
I'm gonna be singing a song called Breathe.
From what?
From In the Heights, which is a musical. Breathe. This is my street, the smile of the faces I've known all my life. They regard me with pride. Everyone's sweet, they say you're going places. So how can I say the girl I was away? I had so much to hide. Hey guys, it's me. The biggest disappointment, you know. The kid couldn't hack it. She's back. She's walking in. So welcome home. Just breathe. Just breathe. As the radio plays, the forgotten boleros, I think of the days when the city was mine. I remember the phrase, I te adoro, te quiero. The neighborhood waved and said, Nina, be brave and you're gonna be fine. Maybe it's me, but it all seems like lifetimes ago. So what do I say to these faces that I used to know? Hey, I'm home. Hey, they're not worried about me. They are all counting on me to succeed. I am the one who made it out, the one who always made the grade. Well, maybe I should have just stayed up. When I was a child, I stayed wide awake, climbed to the highest place on every fire escape. Restless to climb, I got every scholarship, saved every dollar. The first to go to college, how I tell them why. I'm coming, I'm home, with my eyes on the horizon. Just me and GWB, asking Gina, what'll you be? Straight and spine, smile for the neighbors, everything's fine, everything's cool. The standard reply, lots of tests, lots of papers, smile, wave goodbye, and pray to the sky. Oh God, and what will my parents say? Can I go in there and say, I know that I'm letting you down?
Back to you, Jeff.
And that leads us to our next topic. This is a serious thing. I have a service announcement for the church. Mother Brenda asked me to think about coping mechanisms this week. So here's my coping mechanism. Stop thinking. It's working for me. I haven't used my higher brain functions in about 3 or 4 years now. Sure, I can't drive a forklift anymore, although oddly they still let me drive a car. I find it difficult to walk up and down flights of stairs. However, there's a lot of things I don't have to think about. So what I was going to suggest to you is considering the same thing. Just stop thinking. Now, if you think that I haven't been able to function in this capacity, just ask Julian Betts. When we work the parish breakfast together, I sometimes try to force the dishes backwards through the Hobart dishwasher just to make them dirty again. He thinks it's silly, but somehow it works for me. Next, we have Virginia Sublett. She is going to perform for us. Virginia, what have you done?
Well, good evening, everybody. Nice to see you here, and hope you enjoy this open mic night. I'm going to sing I Only Have Eyes for You. It's by Al Dubin and Harry Warren, and was originally written in 1934. So enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you, Virginia. That was very lovely. We really appreciate all that you do for St. Andrews. So now I've got, for your benefit here, my second idea for a coping mechanism. Get plenty of sleep. If you're getting ready for bed at night and you're planning on watching something just before you go to sleep, if it's got this kind of graphic, don't watch it. This is something that will keep you awake at night. You'll get a disturbing sleep and you won't do very well in the morning. It'll make it more difficult for you to stop thinking in the morning as well. What you want to do is you want to choose something with a soothing or nostalgic concept to it. There are only two types of shows that you can watch. One is Grace and Frankie, and the other one is Star Trek. It may seem like an odd combination, but Star Trek has all of these hokey, really old-time graphics that run in the episode, and you'll just laugh until you cry. And Grace and Frankie, nothing bad ever really happens in that show, and you'll be able to sleep throughout the entire night. Next up, we have Joe Arlotskis. Joe, what are you gonna do for us?
All right, I'm gonna be doing a tune by Dave Brubeck called Take Five. Thank you, Jeff, for that introduction. I loved Triceratops as a kid growing up, my favorite dinosaur. And Virginia, that was a nice piece. So I'll take it away from here.
They did a lot of those things, but did not limit
I'm sorry. I was just going to say I really get proud of anybody who can learn to play the guitar. I've been working with this one for years, and I haven't been able to figure out anything on it at all. So our next performance is from Stephen Vaughn. Stephen, take it away.
Sorry, I gotta deal with the dogs.
That's the problem with great musicians all the time. They even had a song about it. While Stephen's gone, I'll remind everybody that it was Who Let the Dogs Out? I don't know who recorded it.
All right, so I'll be performing Evermore from Beauty and the Beast.
I wrote called Save Me. Could someone tell me if that you can hear the piano while I do have the microphone on?
Why don't you test it real quick for us?
So like da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
Yep, you're in good shape.
Okay.
your soul's on fire. All around is your heart's desire. Out of reach, incomplete, searching for that sense of peace. But save me, over and over. Reveal me, reveal me, out of the dark. Be not afraid, you're with me always.
Original. Yeah, that was
thank
nice.
You, Will. That was terrific. That concludes the entertainment of our portion of our evening. On behalf of St. Andrews, I'd like to thank each of the performers and all of the people who helped with tonight's program. God bless you all.
And the rest of you, I mean, not the rest of you, but all of you, we can have a little happy hour and chat if you want to stay on. I'm going to stop the recording. There we go.